Morning, everyone. I hope you enjoyed your weekend. Right, I'm just going to work out something to do. Because I paint so many paintings, it's quite hard to sometimes decide on what to do without reference to reference material. I've got ultramarine, these are still on the palette from Saturday. Ultramarine, cadmium red, burnt sienna, black, green, yellow, pale yellow, cadmium pale yellow, and yellow ochre. Yeah, that's all right, still a bit soft. The black, I very rarely use black, but it's a very useful colour. It's the slowest drying colour on the palette, so you have to make allowances for that. I'm just going to, just a simple rural scene, really. Right, well, let's start. I'm going to use one of these lovely pro art brushes. A bit wider than I thought. These are 30 millimetres instead of 25 millimetres, which is what I ordered. But anyway, let's have a go. We want some black and some blue, some white, some red. Quite heavy, huh? Bit of white. I think that red is needs to be added to. So this is a vermilion. There's hardly any difference between vermilion and cadmium red. Squeeze the tube a bit, get the paints up to the top. Oh, we also have some linseed oil, I think. I bought a bottle of this probably 3 years ago now, 1 litre, still going. Linseed oil, pure cold pressed linseed oil. But it's not artist quality, so. So what I do, I add a bit of liquid to the mix, and that will get into the linseed and help to dry it. So we just a lot. Right, here we go. Right, now what have we got on there? Oh, let's have a bit of ochre, touch of red. Right, okay, that will do for a start. Now we'll put in some. I'll get a lighter horizon. I mean that. That is just a bit bland. So let's go with a bit of burnt sienna. Put some tark in there. Go back to that lighter colour. This is on the oil paper. It's an A4 sheet I cut from the A3. So you can get, I get two for the price of one. And it's a really good paper. I'm going to do my usual. I am a bit stuck for what to paint, but let's just. Back to some watercolours soon. Right, let's put in some trees now. Trees, black. Let's make a nice green look. Turn this into one of the Rutland scenes where we were a week or so ago. The yellow is a bit sticky. Right, okay, a bit of a stormy sight, very similar to what's going on outside my windows, my roof lights. Well, we can just get that bit higher. Right, let's get those trees, some of those trees higher. Get a bit of water in there, I think. Uh, bit of a darker kind of in that. Oops. It's got a little bit of a bit of warmer colour in it. Here and there. Okay. It's all a bit layerish, but let's put in some Oh, I guess 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. All right, well, let's see if we can improve the colour. Warm up some of this. touch of oak, of burnt sienna. So this turned out to be a tutorial on trees and water. No apologies for that. The paper is soaking up the oil now, which is lovely. It's one of its characteristics. It's got a membrane at the back of it. It's a bit like this. Oh no, it's not. It's grey outside. Oh, one window, it's a faint blue sky brightening up the other side of my left hand side. It's not very good. Some bright here. Let's have a bit of a right, let's see if I can get a bit of light. Just feather that, just down into that bit of water. Right, I'm going to let that go. That's all I've got time for at the moment. I've got to take my wife, I've got to go and let my son's dog out. And I've got to take my wife to the hospital for a check-up. So it's quite a lot on today. Right, let's get the mount. Well, there we are. So, we've got some sort of landscape there, waterscape. I'm going to let that go. Clip that on there. Right. I hope you take something from that, folks. I didn't. This is the problem. When you, as I say, so early that so when you when I do so many paintings, the repetition is always, even in the painting, is a trap. I've got a nice back bit of toweling now, so I'll clean the brushes through that, and then I'll go and wash them in fairy liquid to leave my hands all nice and clean and soft. Bye for now.